Today I'm hunting with Dave Miles. He's fresh off the NRA show. He's a little bit tired. He's not really cranky, but like Barney Fife, his trigger finger is starting to kind of get a little bit of schizophrenia, and we need to cure that.
Mossberg's Rugged American Hunter with Jason Cruz.
When I was coming down to go to the NRA show here in Nashville, one of the great things that I had lined up was that I got to come hunt with Jason. Jason does a lot of great stuff for Mossberg. I was really excited about the opportunity to not only hunt with Jason, but also hunt in Tennessee.
We got in really close this morning, under a cedar tree, brushed in real good, and we're waiting for the day to start. And I knew it was gonna be great. It's always great along that creek bed. Dave only had a day to hunt, so I was like, man, let's just go right to the roost.
There they are.
On our side?
Yep.
Okay.
You can see them strutting out there.
Oh, on the other side?
Yep.
Yeah, I caught a glimpse of them just now.
There's a big butterball right there.
Yeah, I see him.
Must have seen six gobblers fly out of the trees, a bunch of hens, but they kind of headed off. And later on in the day, around 10 o'clock, as Jason said in one of his tips, he kills a lot of birds after 10. We had a turkey by himself, gobbling all by himself. He kind of surprised us. We started calling, he was responding.
They just went a different direction doing what turkeys do. And I said, I've got another farm that I really do think we can get on them. This particular farm is usually just lightning great up in the middle of the day, and 11:30 was when we first pulled up. And just last year, on the last week of the season, I rolled up, I was getting my stuff out of the truck, and he gobbled, and he just sounded like he needed killing. Early on when I began turkey hunting, one of the greatest mistakes I made was I would walk through the woods or just walk through a farm, and I would call to turkeys from all kinds of locations. And I learned that that was really a really bad way to hunt. And here's why. A turkey, the best response that you can get from a strutter is that he comes to you. Well, if you're walking, how many times have you called and nothing hammered? And 100 yards up, you run slap into him. He was walking your way. Especially old birds, they'll do that. They'll just start committing and come investigate you. So I've made a commitment that I never call to a turkey until I'm in a position that I want to kill him from or in that context. I want to make sure that when I do call, if he answers, I can sit down. And that's exactly what Dave and I did today. We got on top of this knob and I said, if he gobbles at us up in here, we can kill him from right here. Dave, a lot of times up in the day, these birds, you know, we heard that one hen yelping, but nothing yep. gobbled at her. I'm figuring if there was something with her, we'd have known it.
Yep.
I tell you what, I'm gonna walk a few feet ahead of you so I don't blow in your ear where okay. you can hear. If you hear a gobble, just point.
Okay.
I don't want to walk too much further past this because it's pretty open down there.
Yep. right down there. Hen calling too.
But he's a long way away.
He is, right? A long way, up on the ridge.
Yeah, that's good though. Okay, all right, well, let's do this. I've killed more than one turkey on this road bed. Mm-hmm. Let's go back. It'll be like a hen moving out.
Okay.
And we'll just wait him out. Rain's coming. Yep. Let's just try it.
Sounds good.
My favorite way to kill a bird is to do exactly what Dave Miles and I did. We went backward. We didn't go maybe another 70 yards back, but it was enough distance in the calling, but really to make a hen like she was further away, not much. But more than anything, we put a small rise between us and that tom, and he's got to come over it to see that hen. And that's what he had to do. And it is the absolute best method I've ever seen. If you can find any kind of elevation change where you can pull him up just a little, I mean, you can just... I got a feeling he's gonna come up that road bed.
Did you hear that?
Yeah.
I think it's closer.
Yeah, I think he's down in the bottom. Oh man, that's gonna be great.
Come on.
Hey Dave, I'm gonna hit him again.
Okay. There he goes again.
Yeah. Okay.
He's coming.
Yeah. He's closer for sure. I see him.
Okay. Dave Miles. Hey, you know what? The boss bird met the moss bird, baby.
Oh, my.
Was that a show?
That was awesome.
That's how we do it in Tennessee, Mr. Ooh. Connecticut.
Oh, man, I'm excited about this, Jason. Thank you.
Yeah.
I heard him gobble again. I knew he was coming.
Well, and you know what? When birds get down in bottoms like that, hunting these hills all my life, they sound further away, but they're not.
Oh, yeah. How long could you see him before then?
Did you hear me say I see him? No. I saw him when he first put his head up on the rise.
I saw the white ball.
Yeah.
And then I was like, all right, I'm going to let him keep coming. Well, Jason, I tell you what, that's point of aim, point of impact. This is one nice bird. Look at him. Gorgeous Tennessee gobbler.
When he came over that ridge, it was all
I could see. Is that all you saw?
I saw those tops. Yep. I'm like, oh man, he's there.
His head was about bright white.
Oh, I'm telling you.
As soon as I saw him, I was just kind of looking down and all of a sudden I saw him. I'm sure you saw him before I did.
Yeah.
Because we were separated a little bit, but wow. I love turkey hunting.
I love
turkey hunting when it works the way it's supposed to.
That's right.
Ugh. Good stuff. Hunting today, we're hunting with a Mossberg 930 semi-automatic, 3-inch chambered shotgun. And the only thing that was different for me, I have a JM Pro, which is the same model, but I use it for 3-gun shooting. Today I was hunting with a turkey gun. The only thing different was it had a pistol grip, and I hadn't used it before, but I'll tell you one thing that was nice about it was that pistol grip really gives good control when you have to rest the gun on your knee.
You know, I like history, and I am really humbled to get to be a part of the Mossberg story. When you look at how far back that story goes, 1919, I can't imagine just how proud O.F. Mossberg would be of where his people have gone and where they're going today. When you look, that story has so many old chapters, but with so many new beginnings. At Mossberg, we're creating content all the time. You can go to mossberg.com and click on the YouTube icon and see all kinds of content that's out there for shooting, waterfowl, just whatever kind of genre you like.